Namaskar, welcome you all in this video. Today I am going to continue with class 9th chapter Matter in Our Surroundings. So in previous class, in previous video, we discussed the important properties of matters. So now we are going to discuss these properties by two important activities. Let's begin the class. We were going to explain, understand the two activities which are based on the properties of matter. The first activity is particles are very tiny. Yes, we already discussed yesterday that matter particles are made up of small tiny particles which are known as atoms. Hence, the particles of matter are very tiny and indivisible. Now for this experiment, we require glass A and glass B. In glass A, first we need to add water, then few drops of ink, and we have to add more amount of water in glass A solution. So what is going to happen? Whenever we are adding drop of ink in water glass A, we will come to know that the color of the water changes from transparent to the color of ink. Now on more dilution, whenever we are adding more amount of water in the above solution, we will understand that later on the color gets fainted. So this could be our observation that on dilution, whenever we are adding more amount of on dilution, the color gets fainted. So the conclusion is small particles of ink contains many tiny particles. That is why they easily get intermixed and form a particular solution. Now we are going to see this activity through an experiment. Here we are having glass filled with water, and now I am going to add ink, drop of red ink into it. Earlier the color of water is transparent. Now after adding red color ink, the color of the water changes into light red. So this is showing that yes, the particles of the ink are mixed with the particles of water. Now on adding more amount of water, the dilution, the color of this solution fainted. So this is showing that yes, the particle of the ink which are mixed in the particle of water, they intermix completely, so that they show that the property of matter having tiny particles. Let's continue with the next activity number 2. The property of matter showing that the particles are having inter-particle space between them. That when the particle of matter contains many spaces which is negligible to see or invisible through our naked eyes. So this we can explain the property with the help of this experiment. Let's see. For this experiment we need a glass, then add a water into it, then add 1 spoon of table salt, which is known as NaCl, or in the chemical name of NaCl is sodium chloride. The formula is NaCl. It is having an ionic bond. Okay, so the table salt we are adding in a water on dilution, on dissolution, we will get a particular solution of NaCl in water, and this solution is a true solution, a homogeneous solution. Homo means same, solution. Whenever the particles are completely mixed and form a clear solution, that is known as homogeneous solution. So the above experiment observation is, even on adding small quantity of NaCl, the volume of water remains same. It will not increase. It remains constant. Means whenever I am adding salt in water, the volume of the water remains same. It means there is some space present between the water molecule itself, which is known as interparticle space, which is occupied by the NaCl. Let's come to the conclusion of this activity. Particles of water are loose and have a specific space between them, which is accommodated by the NaCl particle and form a true solution. Let's see this experiment through an activity. Here I am having a water filled in a glass, and this is table salt. Now I am going to add a spoon of table salt
into this water. Now we need to dissolve it. After some time, on complete dissolution, this becomes a clear solution, which is known as homogeneous solution, and the volume of the water remains the same. It does not increase. Hence, I can say that on dissolving or adding NaCl into water, the water volume remains constant, but the complete dissolution of NaCl particle into the water takes place. Hence, it shows that water particles are having interparticle spaces in which the sodium chloride particles dissolve and takes place. So in this way, we can explain the properties of matter. Hence, it is completed. Thank you so much for this video. We will continue the next topics in coming videos. Have a nice day. Goodbye.